Good afternoon, friends. Because today we need to talk about some lantana camera toxicity. Because lantana camera is one of the most noxious weed in this earth and causing a lot of toxicity in case of the cattle are concerned. Because many times the sheep, then the HF or Jersey cattle, they go for grazing and eat this, particularly the red color lantana camera, which is highly toxic among all the five type of the plants. Number one is the pink, then yellow, then white, and the red. So red one is most toxic and noxious weed. And it's very interesting to know that how this lantana camera came to India. So it's also one of the interesting story that this Christian missionaries during 1980s, they brought this lantana camera in the form of the bouquet to give as a token of reward, especially to the West Bengal. It came to the Calcutta first, then it was transmitted from Calcutta to the Bangalore, then later it was taken to Pune. Then later, even though it came to India as an ornamental plant, it spread like a wildfire. And now we can see everywhere this lantana is present, all the varieties are present, lantana camera. So lantana camera, it's also a double-edged sword because it occupies the earth to the greater extent and will never allow any other plant to grow. So of course, you might have seen that Parthenium histoporus, another important and noxious weed, it's also going to occupy the entire part and sucking the nutrition of all other plants. But at the same time, wherever the lantana is there, the Parthenium will not grow. And wherever the Parthenium is dominant, then the lantana will grow. This is the dominant and recessive pattern of the lantana and the Parthenium. Of course, the Euphotorium is another plant, which is also another weed and causes lot of what you call as the menace to the environment is concerned. Then coming to the lantana camera, it's a weed, and whenever the animals do have the deficiency of the green powder, especially during the winter, the starting up of the winter and in the summer season, so the animals are going to graze this plant. And especially in case of the order of toxicities like that, the Bos taurus cattle, they do not have much what you call as this taste sense, etc. So they eat this plant very commonly. Then the sheep and goat, and also the goats, they do succumb to the poisoning of lantana camera plant. But at the same time, one thing you have to remember that the buffaloes, they also succumb to the lantana camera poisoning. We have seen that in the Ron Taluk of the northern part of Karnataka, in the Kapatakota area, about hundreds of animals have been suffered from lantana camera poisoning, and we are seeing this lot of deaths are being reported in the sheep and also the goats, because goats are the voracious browsers, and of course they are little resistant to the lantana camera. And the monogastric animals are little bit resistant to the lantana camera poisoning, and hence they succumb less. Of course the dogs and cats, no, they are not going to eat the lantana camera. Very rare cases, it's one or two cases in the world, they have reported that the animals are selectively going to consume the flower of this particular plant and succumb to the toxicity. So it is a rare phenomenon especially. So what happens is, whenever the animals consume more than 50 grams per kg of this lantana camera, then they will succumb to the toxicity. They might have consumed a lot less also, but nothing is going to happen. At the same time, if they consume the lethal dose, so it ranges from 10 grams to 50 grams per kg depending upon the time. Suppose in the winter the plant is dry, its water content is less, then less dose may also be more toxic. Hence, such situation we have to see that the plant, this season, the breed, all these have got lot of variations. So in total, what we can say is the plant causes the toxicity when it is exceeded the dose. It might have consumed the other plants also at the same time, then these toxins get diluted. So immediately after consumption, the mechanism of action is like this. So the plant is consumed by a ruminant and it goes to the stomach, means the rumen, where it's a very big fermentation vat. It's containing the capacity of 150 liters, especially in a large ruminant, which is weighing especially 350 kgs. The rumen itself procures about the 150 liters. That means approximately one third of the weight of that ruminant is the rumen content. So it's going to be metabolized to four type of the toxins, that's called as the lantadines A and B and C and D. Lantadine A, lantadine B, lantadine C and lantadine D. These are the important plant toxins. So these are going to be absorbed into the circulation. Then what happens is lantadine A and B are very important and very potent plant toxins. They are going to the liver, then they are going to be excreted in the liver, then they are going to occlude the bile duct so that the cholestasis occurs. That's called as the jaundice. What we can see that the clinical signs of the yellowishness tinged throughout the what you call as the mucous membrane. All the mucous membrane becomes very yellow, then the urine becomes yellow, the milk becomes yellow, etc. So this takes about 3 to 4 days. Suddenly it is not going to happen today. If the animal has consumed, then it may happen 2 to 3 days after. Whereas the what you call as the toxin is metabolite of that toxin, which is called as the pyloerythrin, is going to accumulate beneath the skin of the animals, and when the animals are going to the bright sunlight, then there is a photoreaction occurs there. Then at that time this is a photosensitization occurs. So the photosensitization is one of the serious reactions in which there is a what you call as the eruption of the skins. The white part of the, especially in case of the HF cows, it's going to be eruptated out. Hence one should be careful that the cows should not go and eat the lantana, and at the same time if you do suspect that they have consumed the lantana chondro poisoning, they should not be let out for the grazing, especially the sunlight. Because when the sunlight is being exposed to the animal's skin, then photodynamic reactions occurs, the entire skin will peel off. So then the animal will be suffer from lot of itching. It will go and rub its, they call as the skin, to a wall or any other hard material. So there is a chance that the skin gets sloughed off. Hence, you should be very careful about the animal. If it is suffering from any of the symptoms, like it wants always the shade and it wants to drink cool water, then please allow the animal to stay in the shade only. Many of the times the animals, they are shy of the sunlight. So that's why you should not let them for the further grazing, or else what happens is further exposure of the animal occurs and it will end up in more and more toxicity, severe toxicity occurs. Of course we can treat the jaundice, but especially the eruption of the skin, etc., if it takes place, skin eruption, it takes long time to treat with the antibiotics. Then also some of the ointments are required, and also sometimes the what you call as the anti-tick medicines are also required. Hence we should not make the further aggravation of the this way, especially the photosensitization. Yes, that's one part. Whereas the second part is the what you call as the bile stasis or cholestasis. So the animal will suffer from severe constipation because of the improper flow of the bile, especially the intestinal stasis occurs, and hence the animal will suffer from lot of constipation. 2 or 3 days it will not defecate at all. Then the other signs, it will totally stop taking the feed, and the farmer says, sir, my cow is not taking the feed, please do something. So this is one of the toughest tasks, because maybe thousands of diseases are there in the veterinary, and to which only few we have got the specific antidotes. And any disease of any toxicity, any disease, the animal stops the feeding. So we have to diagnose the condition very properly, then you have to give the history, the clinical signs which is suffering. The diagnostic part of that particular this thing takes, is very important that the history should be given. Yes, that's one. Then there is a stasis of the or stagnation of movement of the this especially the stagnated lantana camera will be struck in the rumen. Then further absorption of the toxins takes place. If it is there, stasis means further absorption of the this especially the toxin takes place. There is complete anorexia, partial to complete anorexia. There is jaundice, there is skin eruptions or photosensitization. And sometimes in case of sheep, what happens is the because of these photosensitization reactions, the head of the sheep get swollen. That's called cause the swollen head disease. Many times in blue tongue also similar to that, blue tongue or in the other viral disease due to the toxemia or other thing, the head will be swollen. So this is called as the swollen head syndrome, the toxicity of lantana camera. Then what is the line of treatment? That's why the doctors ask, what is the line of treatment? How your veterinary doctor is going to treat that particular disease, especially the toxicity of lantana camera? So first of all, he will advise you to prevent the animal from further grazing up of the toxins or toxin containing plant. Number one, we should prevent the animal for the further exposure of the toxic weed, or else it will go and eat and accumulate more and more toxic plant and get more and more toxicity. That's number one. Number two is, please make the animal to stay in the shade, maybe a shed or maybe especially below the tree or under any of the shades, so that the exposure of the animal makes more and more photosensitization. That's number two. First of all, we have to confine the animal to the confined area, maybe a cattle shed. Then the third is line of the treatment is to administer the antihistamines, which are very required because the photosensitization reaction here caused lot of itching and discomfort to the animals. And if the itching is too much, then we need to administer the steroids also. But we should take care that the animal is not pregnant at that time. The doctors, there are many of the steroids are there in which this abortion is not going to happen. So he will take care that the steroid is there. Then if already eruption has happened and the bacterial infection started, then he may use some of the antibiotic of his choice, especially the antibiotics of his choice. Then the fourth line of the treatment is administration of the activated charcoal, which is very, very important, which adsorbs, means stops the further absorption of the lantadine A, B, C and D to be absorbed into the circulation. So we have to administer the activated charcoal. Please remember that the activated charcoal and the regular charcoal, which is available in the farmer's doorstep, are totally different. Their chemical entity itself is different. So never advise the owner, or the owner should not take that the charcoal, which is wood oriented charcoal, in their home. Should be not to be crushed, and it should be drenched to the animal. So what is an activated charcoal? It is a commercial preparation available in the market, either in the form of the medicines or it's readily available as the solutions. So the dose of this activated charcoal is usually 1 gram per kg, means it's very easy to remember. If the animal is weighing 350, then 350 grams, or else the double of the dose may also be required if the animal has consumed more and more poisonous plant. Then never administer atropine sulfate as the antidote to lantana camera poisoning. I request all the veterinarians who are hearing this thing, especially this video, never administer the atropine sulfate as an antidote or any of the treatment in any of the plant toxicity. So please use this caution. Never administer atropine sulfate to any of the plant toxicity other than the organophosphorus compounds or carbamates. Only these two conditions you have to use, or else never touch your atropine sulfate for the line of treatment of any of the toxicity. Then what else? Yes, the activated charcoal I was mentioning, it should be about sometimes it may require up to 1 kg also, depending upon the toxicity, especially in large animals, and 250 to 300 gram in case of sheep and goat. How to make it to be administered? That's very, very important. This the activated charcoal. If it is, it need to be, if it is 1 kg dose or sometimes half kg, 8 times water should be put in a container. 1 is to 8, 1 kg means 8 liter of water, and make it as a slurry. Don't too much dilute it, or it should not be too thicky. Then administer it very slowly. I repeat, administer it very slowly, very scientifically and very properly. Because most of the time, if you advise the owner to drench it, they will end up in aspiratory pneumonia. Means it will go to the lungs through the trachea, and it is the death of the animal. Once the activated charcoal goes inside, maybe 10 or 15 gram also it goes, means the severe aspiratory pneumonia will occur. Most of the your alveoli, especially the bronchioles, bronchial tree, etc., will be blocked, and the animal succumb to aspiratory pneumonia and it will die. So whenever you are going to administer the activated charcoal in a sheep herd, please demonstrate how to administer a activated charcoal. Meantime, the shepherds are quite intelligent, they may drench, but please see that it directly goes to the rumen. Especially if it's a large animal, try to use the stomach tube and pass it yourselves. No, do not allow the owner to make it to be drenched. That's number one. And another thing is sufficient administration of sufficient quantity of the fluids. Because yes, if you administer how much quantity, sufficient quantity, and what type of the fluids, especially any balanced electrolyte, glucose solutions, or sometimes the calcium may also be required. Balanced electrolytes may be containing 20% dextrose or sometimes 10% dextrose, so okay, no problem. How much quantity to be administered is usually 10 ml per kg. Suppose the cow is meeing, a minimum, that's not the minimum, and depending upon the dehydration and the duration of anorexia, etc., you need to administer it's more also and less also, depending. You are the person who has to decide. So sufficient quantity of the fluid to be administered properly once, twice in a day till the animal recovers, or else the animal will suffer lot of anorexia, and the ketosis may start, and the fat mobilization starts, and the milk yield will be drastically reduced. So please administer the fluid, and sometimes the B complex vitamins are also required. So administer sufficient B complex vitamins in the form of the injections, etc. Here no antibiotics are required if the animal has not started the eruption of the skin. So no antibiotics are required. And any other supporting treatment like calcium, borogluconate, half bottle, you can administer slow IV. Always administer the IV injections, very slow IV. And apart from this one, you can also administer the cathartics or the purgatives. Suppose the purgatives are the magnesium sulfate, is a osmotic purgatives, and it makes the fluid to be drawn from the intestine, and it forms a bulk and forms, especially the purgation is caused. The peristaltic movements will start and purgation will start. And you need to administer sufficient quantity of the water. If the animal is in dehydrated stage, the diarrhea will not occur if you administer the, especially the magnesium sulfate. So what you can do is, there is a one small simple technique known as the oral hydration therapy. This is very simple, I can explain, and you can also see some of the photographs in my earlier videos, that in every farmer's house there is a hose pipe is there, and there is a tap. So you have to take the hose pipe with your hand, put it into the one end to the tap. Yes, that's finished. One end, there is a tap, and see the pressure of that, particularly the water, and see in such a way that a mild flow is there, and put another end of this hose pipe in the mouth of the animal. Never make the animal's head up more than 45 degree this thing. Then slowly administer the water, remove the tap, and some part of the water may spill out, nothing bother, but make it to drench at least 60 to 70 liter of water, or 5 to 10 buckets of water. So many times this causes a very good hydration of the animal, and almost all the parts of the body will be reached with the hydrogen, especially H2O molecule, and the sufficient called as the diuresis occurs, and also the peristalsis occurs and the poison gets out. And at the same time, if more and more urine is formed, then the poison will get out of the body. This is how the line of treatment goes, because many times if you administer the blood fluid, so you have to stand by the side of the animal at least for 2 to 3 hours. So totally practically it's impossible. Many times the animals struggle and the vein will come up. So because of this thing, you have to undertake this water oral hydration therapy. If you have got 2 or 3 sachets of electrolyte, etc., that's also can be put in the mouth of the animal and slowly administer the water. That's the good line of the treatment, especially in case of the blind toxicity, the animals will never drink the water. So this will become one of the very good line of the treatment. Then what else you can do? So number one, you have to summarize this thing. The number one, you have to further avoid the plant grazing, then administer sufficient quantity of the fluids, treat the what you call as photosensitization, administer the activated charcoal, administer antihistamines or the antibiotics if they are required, and also the hydration therapy and also the purgatives. So if the magnesium sulfate, when you administer, it takes about 6 to 12 hours depending upon the water quantity in the body of the animal to purgate. So if it has not purgated, means you can also go for the liquid paraffin or the glycerin or any other preparations which are having the mineral oils, etc., with good laxative effect, or you can also combine these things. And once the animal start purgation well and fine, many times if it have super purgation may also happen, then please watch the animal's heart rate, body temperature, etc. If the body temperature risen, means it is the indication of the photosensitization. That's one. Then, so these are all the things, your prognosis, means might graded as the good, bad or grave. Means most of the time the animals are going to recover if you have administered the treatment in proper time and proper management. So sometimes it may take more days also. Sometimes the animals will be anorectic, so need days also. At that time, what you can do is the transposition of the rumen cud. You can bring one of the rumen content or the cud from the healthy animal or transfer it to the suffering. Or also market from the slaughterhouse also, you can procure the rumen, then make the animal to eat that particular rumen cud. So this makes the animal to recover very fast. And apart from this one, the other line of the treatment is N-acetylcysteine. It's available as tranebamil injection and you can also administer. And many times the prokinetic drugs like the metoclopramide or the perinol, so these can also be used as 10 ml for 3 days if it is required, or else not necessary. These are all the line of the treatment which is available for the especially for the treatment of the lantana camera. And take care the animal drinks sufficient water and other thing once it's completely recovers, and see that it is not going for further. And suppose the animal dies many times, what happens if we need to conduct the postmortem? And in the postmortem you can see that lot of engorged rumen with the lantana camera plant is number one, and severe constipated especially the feces, then entire body will be icteric in the, because there is a cholestasis and bile has been absorbed into the circulation. That's the important thing. Suppose if you know a valuable animal has consumed the lantana camera or day or two, within 2 days, then the plant will be staying in the rumen itself, then you can conduct the rumenotomy. But explain the owner the advantages of rumenotomy immediately. If you remove, that's very well and fine, and the animal will recover very fantastically. But the owner should respect the word of the veterinarian. You trust your veterinarian, and let him conduct the rumenotomy. A simple operation, it's not a complicated operation. See, the difference between the conducting the operation and treatment are totally different. Once the poison has absorbed into the circulation, you have to do lot of exercise to get rid of the poison out of the body. But before that thing, if you simply do the rumenotomy and take the plant out and put some what you call as this rumen cut inside, the animal's recovery will be very fast. This is learned by the research. lot of research have been conducted, and it's totally a success story itself. So these are all the things about to need to learn about the Lantana Capra poisoning, especially the sheep, cattle, especially the ruminants. And thank you very much for the hearing. Any of the comments and other things you can put in the comment section. So I will be coming with different videos time to time, and thank you.